Queens is a melting pot of ethnic backgrounds. It gave me a sense of worldliness that I didn't know I was getting because it was diverse in terms of people. Where I grew up in Queens, it was a city inside a city. When I left home for the first time, I realized that there were more people in my apartment complex than there was in my college town. We're in the epicenter of LeFrak City, right in the heart. This is now named the Kenny Smith Basketball Court. I live right there in the 12th floor, and my mom used to be able to see me play right on the court. For me, LeFrak City taught you how to be a kid, but at the same time, be a smart kid. We didn't have the shovels, we had the boot shovel. You take the boot and everybody get the boot and you start kicking and you'll make enough just for the half court. Believe it or not, there's another Kenny from LeFrak who also hit it big.
This is where I started, you know, playing ball at when I was like 10 years old.
Kenny Anderson's the best high school guard I've ever seen anywhere. First time I saw him in the sixth grade, he was special.
And here's Anderson!
But Queens is a big place, and through the generations, players from all over the borough have made their mark on basketball history.
This Cousy coming out of Queens, he was the genius. Bob Cousy had a genius gene in him.
Queens were the guys who we always thought we were the thinking man's player. Brooklyn had a toughness about him, a grittiness. Manhattan had a suave about him. We understand the science of the game. We all got our start on the playground, but in Queens, there's also a legendary gym.
When it rained, everybody went to Lost Battalion Hall on Queens Boulevard.
It's special to me, it's the first place I ever played basketball. I got out of school at 3, I was here by 5. I do my homework for an hour and a half, and I was in this gym from 5 to 10 every night. One of my funniest stories started here. I was 10 years old, and the first time I was ever in a close game. And so my coach calls timeout, we're up 3 points, and he says, okay, we're gonna just run the clock out and sit on the ball and not let the team get it. So we throw the basketball in, I grab the ball and I take it, and I sit on it. I never heard that term before. Lost Battalion is where I learned the game, but Archbishop Molloy High School holds a special place in my heart. I even named my son Molloy Adrian Smith. It's a fitting tribute to my old school and my head coach, the late, great Jack Curran.
Kenny himself, you know, was a very receptive student of basketball. His game was there, it just had to be polished.
I wasn't instantly great. I was a guy that you put in the oven, you looked, checked on, oh, he's getting there, he's not ready yet. And then all of a sudden, my senior year, first team All-American. You looked in the oven, it was like, yo, he's ready. Throughout my career, I never forgot those lessons learned back in Queens. And no matter where I went, running into other New Yorkers gave me a sense of home. We came from the same cloth.
Another New Yorker.
So when we saw each other, it was like seeing the guy you knew your whole life.
The Jet.
In New York. You
get the nice
New Yorkers stuff. In one place, this is the place
the
to be
jet.
Tonight.
I'm from a Queens state of mind. My thought process of why I do things, how I do them, a lot of it comes from this area.